I'm pissed!
Then let's get that son of a bitch!
Enough. Your line's thirst for all out war with the humans endangers us all. Peter Navano. Without the sheep.
The wolves go hungry, yes. But the day is coming when the sheep will outwit the wolves. Haven't you been watching, brother? The humans have harnessed the power of steam and lightning, and they grow mighty. If our hubris allows us to grow fat and lazy in the shadows, they will soon have the power to hunt us down like dogs.
And so you propose war.
War suggests there is a chance we might lose. I propose we strike with my new asset. We can control the change. Reclaim the Sanguisuja's rightful place at the top of the food chain.
Control the change. Are you mad? Even suggesting such a thing is blasphemy.
Dominic, brother, these are blasphemous times. While my methods may very well be at variance with our tradition, I can tell you one thing. If we don't adapt, we will perish.
Enough. I will not allow you and your bastard breed to lead us into annihilation. Peter Davano, for the high crime of conspiracy against your own kind, I sentence you and your line to the true death.
We had to try, Felicity, Mikara. Our work will be a lot easier if we can help them understand. If we can't...
then... we... force them to!
Thank you. Could have brought a bigger knife.
Some people get a gold watch when they retire. I got Susan here.
Should have asked him how to get out of here.
Too late. He won't be of any use for a month or two. Wait. What about Chester?
Well, what are you gonna do?
Now that is how you shape an explosion. Damn, we're late.
At least we won't be going back to the manor empty-handed.
Thank you.
So this is where those beasts get their magical blood from. Once that ancient fella in Baxter was sucked dry, she found you, huh? Christ, I'm starting to hate mythology.
Up like a mummy in a web. Guess he got away.
Thank you. Thanks for the hand. But I had it under control.
Can tell.
I found the plan. The locals call it La Orquídea de la Vida, or something foreign like that. We get this back to Calico, squeeze it out, and maybe we have ourselves a way to turn this around.
I'm sorry I got you into this.
Yeah. Getting your ass out of the fire has kind of become a habit.
Edgar, you can't keep doing this forever.
When those ticks attacked the manor, what did your father do? Run? Nah. He kept on squeezing the trigger. That's what he did. People like us don't retire, Jesse. Even if you're lucky enough to live long enough, you'll soon realize there's nothing waiting for you. There is no normal for people like me or your father. And I was naive to think there might be some normal for you. Anyway, now that just about everyone else in the Institute is dead, I figure you and your daddy are gonna need all the help you can get to build things back up again.
Well, first you give me those pretty flowers, then you get all emotional on me. Edgar, you ain't gonna try to kiss me now, are you?
You little shit.
Time someone sent in the cavalry. I've been hiding here for a week.
This ain't a rescue mission, so watch your mouth. I'm here to pick up some documents for Assistant Secretary Harrow.
Documents? I don't know anything about any documents. Oh, these documents?
You must be the accountant.
Jonathan Q. Biddle at your service. Mr. Harrow promised me immediate backup, as long as I kept this safe.
Harrow's written you off, Biddle. Sent me for the case, not you. All I know is that DC wants that portfolio seized.
DC? What an asshole. Harrow isn't trying to leverage this property for the government, you ape. He wants it for himself. He wrote me into this scheme for a cut of the profits, and now he's hung me out to dry. That asshole.
How big a cut?
10%.
Hope it was worth all those soldiers' lives, you greedy little pissworm. I'll take that.
Whoa, wait! What about me? How'll I get home?
Walk.
Mm-hmm.
All aboard! The train's about to leave the station. Do you hear them singing? That's humanity's requiem. You can be mankind's last sad note, or you can be part of a new opening chord of progress. It's only natural to feel fear while standing on the precipice of change. Sometimes what you need is a little push. Try not to kill him, my child. Let it break poor William's heart.
Thank you.
Frontier. A final choice. Forget gauntlets and cheap electrical tricks. All that truly stands between us and godhood is a drop of blood.
Is that the same choice you gave to Virgil?
Virgil didn't matter. He had no place in the future. Think of what you could achieve with the power we've been handed. You are worth more than any of them. I cannot apologize for progress. You adapt, or you die.
I've heard those words before. She's in your head.
Enough of your petulance! I am your father! If you will come willingly, I will make you!
Thank you.
This is your last lesson, son!
We'll stop her before she reaches DC.
I taught you well, after all. You just pray it was enough.
Great change. With the president joining our bloodline, sharing his secrets just like your father did, we cannot be stopped!
We'll see about that.
I tried to make you understand. In order to build something, you need to demolish its past.
Your stupid ambition took everything from me. You turned my father against me and everything he stood for. That was a fate worse than death. I'm here to make sure you won't do the same to anyone else.
Thank you. one of us! Rentier, you beautiful son of a bitch. You did it.
The situation is contained, sir. The Institute's resources were finally put to good use. It was just a matter of proper management. We couldn't allow for it to be led like a small-town family business. Or even worse, to be run by a woman.
Sir, this man continuously abused his position of power for personal gain. His poor decisions jeopardized the whole country. And for that alone, he should be put behind bars.
James, Dr. Blackwell here has shared some rather interesting information on your conduct of late. If even half of those allegations are true, I'm afraid you're done for. Mr. Rentier, your father was a great friend. Seeing your performance today, I have no doubt that his legacy is secure. I wonder, it appears we're down a Secretary of War. Ever see yourself in the Capitol, son?
Oh, I ain't much behind a desk.
Fair enough. Then I'll see to it that full control of the Rentier Institute is returned to you. I'm afraid only you have the, necessary skills to deal with a conflict like the one we appear to be facing.
We do, sir. We do. But to win this, we need to be bigger than ever.
And smarter.
With better protocols.
And stronger lines of communication.
Well, it sounds like you two have it all under control. You've got my full support in any way I can provide, son. Carte blanche, as they say. Sky's the limit.